Ryan, are you done with your homework?
One sec, I'm playing an online game.
Well, pause it.
You can't pause an online game. What up, players? Julian here for DNews. Video games have been blamed for the decline of children since Pong. You know the game Pong with the paddles? Look it up. Anyway, whenever something goes wrong with the youth, someone invariably points a finger towards video games. But is it possible someone could play a video game and still do well in school? Well, according to a new study from the Royal Melbourne Institute of Technology, it is in fact possible to enjoy video games regularly and not become a flunky. The study drew data from PISA, the Program for International Student Assessment, an international survey that tests the math, reading, and science skills of 15-year-old students. The survey also collects information like how much time a student spends online playing games and their parents' education level and occupation. Using data from 12,004 Australian students, the researchers assessed the correlation between playing video games online and academic performance. They found that students who played games almost every day performed substantially better in all categories, scoring 15 points above average in math and reading, and 17 points above average in science. How or if video games had an impact on performance is not something that can be figured out from this sort of analysis. It's a classic case of correlation does not necessarily equal causation. The author of the study, Alberto Passo, suggested a few different possible explanations. Maybe the games are having a direct impact when they use concepts from math, science, or language as essential gameplay elements, forcing players to master these concepts to progress in-game. It's also possible that people who enjoy math and reading prefer to play these types of games anyway. Interestingly, the data also shows that more games don't always mean students are more smarterer. While scores generally went up the more students played, they dropped again for students who played every single day, possibly because of the opportunity cost of playing games instead of studying. This isn't the first study to look into the relationship between academic performance and video games, and past research is a bit of a mixed bag. Another study published in Social Psychiatry and Psychiatric Epidemiology in 2006 found that children aged 6 to 11 who play video games are more likely to do well in school. In 2009, PLOS One published a review of PISA results that found playing games had no big impact one way or another. And a study from the University of Missouri-Columbia in the year 2000 found a slight negative correlation between GPA and time spent playing video games. So this new study out of Australia isn't exploring a new idea, but it does claim to control for outside factors like a student's household and school environment better than previous studies. One thing the study didn't mention, though, is what games these students were playing. If you're a gamer, you know that not all games are the same. There are adventure and puzzle games, platformers, MOBAs, RPGs, MMORPGs, RTSs, FPSs, pretty much every acronym you can think of. Could the genre have an impact on learning? Some research says it does. A 2009 study in the journal Issues in Mental Health Nursing concluded violent games correlated to attention problems, while educational games were associated with good academic achievement. A study in Educational Technology Research and Development from 2008 argued that massively multiplayer games promote higher-order thinking. A 2005 paper from the EDUCAUSE Evolving Technologies Committee suggested strategy games foster an understanding of economics and history. An engineering professor at Northern Illinois University found students were more engaged when their homework was to use numerical methods to make a digital race car navigate a track. So, if the content is good and the game doesn't become too time-consuming, it looks like it's possible to be a gamer and a good student. Hey amigos, we heard your preguntas and we are launching DNews in Español. You can check out an episode right here.
Hace más de 65 millones de años, un cometa se estrelló contra la Tierra, matando a casi toda la vida que existía, incluyendo a la gran mayoría de los dinosaurios. Un enorme cráter en el centro de la península mexicana de Yucatán es nuestra prueba maestra. ¿Pero qué es lo que envió a ese cometa a la Tierra?
Now, you may be wondering, what happens in people's brains when they play video games? Well, good news, because Trace has a video on exactly that, and you can find it right here.
Imagine you're trying to get to your familiar place, like your friend's house or a favorite restaurant. Response learning is when your brain creates a map using landmarks. But place learning is an advanced internal map, so you know to turn based on distance and direction, not just like that there's a McDonald's right there.
Does gaming ever cut into your academics, or do you think it's actually helped you in some way? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.